The objective of this interactive simulation is to explain the information that's contained in a psychrometric chart. What we're going to look at here is a snapshot of the interactive simulation where the x-axis is the dry bulb temperature. The y-axis is moisture content, so the fraction, this is kilograms of water per kilogram of dry air. And the saturation line, the thicker solid green line, corresponds to the maximum moisture content when the partial pressure is the saturation pressure. The relative humidity lines corresponds to fractions of saturation, 20% of saturation, for example. The sliders allow you to change the relative humidity and the dry bulb temperature. So remember, the dry bulb temperature is the x-axis. The relative humidity is we're moving to different lines with the sliders. We're not using a slider for the y-axis per se, but to move to a different relative humidity line. Also shown here are the enthalpy lines, the blue lines, the volume, and this is cubic centimeters per kilogram of dry air. So total volume, but kilograms of dry air. That's the red lines. And the idea is in the simulation, we can click various boxes here to make some of the lines visible or not visible so that the overall diagram is not as complicated as a typical psychrometric chart. We've also made the different lines a different color to make them easier to distinguish. And then we can determine things like dew point, wet bulb temperature, enthalpies, and volume. So we'll look at the interactive simulation to better understand the behavior of what the psychrometric chart is representing. So here's the interactive simulation with all the data except for the numerical values for the point shown. And we can change the relative humidity. So remember, we're not changing the y-axis value directly. We're changing which relative humidity curve we're on. And then we can change the dry bulb temperature by moving the point to right or left. So because this is complicated, we can set up so we can remove the grid lines, which makes it a little easier to see what we're looking at. We can also remove the temperature. So these three temperatures, it's indicating the dry bulb temperature, indicating the dew point temperature, where we reach the saturation line, and then the wet bulb temperature, which approximately is the line on the constant enthalpy line. So I can remove those displayed. I can also remove the specific volume lines so that, again, things are less complicated. Can also remove the enthalpy line. So now I just have relative humidity lines, which I could also remove the labels. As things get more complicated, they can get in the way. And now I can display the values, in this case for the moisture content, which is the y-axis value. If I select enthalpy, then the enthalpy value is also displayed. And then specific volume displays the specific volume for this condition. And finally, the dew point temperature and the wet bulb temperature are displayed when you select it. So by selectively picking which data we want to appear on the psychrometric chart, hopefully it's a little easier to understand its behavior so that we can then move around on the chart and observe, as long as we don't go off the chart, of course, we can move around and observe how these various properties change as we change their relative humidity and temperature.